So we've also been working on Charlie's leave it. So I've been randomly dropping things at home and while we're out, dropping food and asking him to leave it. So this is so I have some treats in my hand and I'm just going to drop them and ask him to leave it. Leave it. Good boy. So he sees the food drop. He doesn't go to get it. That's what we want. So I've been using this for a lot of things. Dropping the food and is one. I've also been using it to get him to look away from other dogs. So if he's staring at something else, I'll say that and then he turns to look at me. And so to transfer that verbal cue, you have to kind of mimic my tone of voice. So you can practice now at home if you want to, or listen to my videos. Leave it. So if you change the sing-songiness of that, then he's not going to respond to it. Or if you try to say it in like a serious voice, he probably won't respond to that either. Good dog. Okay. Good boy. His release word is okay for to get up and go do whatever he wants. And then the other thing that we've been working on is his leash walking. So when I'm walking on the street, like if we're doing like an off-leashy kind of thing, I've got him on the really long line. But when we're walking on the street, I just have him on a shorter. I only give him the usual amount, like 6 feet. But I want him to stay close and match paces with me. So I've been saying, with me, and asking him to come over to my left side. And then we start walking. And then, like I'm not holding the leash right now. He's doing this off-leash. We're in a basketball court. And so I'll reward him. Good boy. With me. Good boy. And then to proof that I do some changes of pace and we change up the location and the distraction level. So we'll go a little faster. With me. Good boy. And then we'll go slow. With me. Good boy. So I usually try to do a hand signal for this as well. I usually tap my thigh, but he doesn't, he's like kind of scared for some reason when I do it. So I'm going to keep working on it and see if he'll, with me, and see if he'll respond to that so you don't have to use a high voice when you ask him. So, and then the other thing is, so if we're walking and he's going a little too far, good boy, sit. If he's going, sit. If he goes a little too far ahead, like he pulls out in front, I say slow. And I'll say it kind of like slow in a deep voice. And then if he's not responding, then I'll just turn around and do a 180 and walk in the other direction until he starts to check back in. So if we're in a new place and he's really excited, sometimes I need to do a couple of 180s in a row or a few just to get his focus. And then if he starts to get too jacked up about another dog, which is his main thing, sometimes it's like a dog in a window or a dog at someone's house, spit that out. Spit. A dog in someone's window or something like that. Something barking at him that he's really excited about. Then I will just grab him close to his collar. So I'll just grab the leash nice and tight and I'll say no. Like if he's really getting crazy, like if he looks like he's about to start lunging and barking at them, you can feel it in his energy. It really shifts. He gets really hyper focused. I will, just because he's such a big dog, I like to preemptively tell him that's not right. So before he even gets really excited, once he's gotten to the point where he's lunging or barking or whatever, it's kind of over. You've missed the opportunity to stop him. So you just need to walk away. No, you're not having any more. You're not allowed to eat these. So that's it. I'll do another video of us just leash walking so you can see it.